Hello, my beautiful people. What's up, everyone? Yes, I know you're surprised. Of course, I am too. That was Chidinma Ojukwu being whisked out of court after she remand order was after a remand order was granted. Yes, Chidinma in a private car. Of course, in a private car. You heard me right now. Obi Chidinma Idisiso. This case is just somehow. She is she's supposed to be a suspect, not just a suspect, but she killed a billionaire. She killed a human being. And now they carry out concords with a private car, okay? And it says a magistrate court in Yaba today, August 9, granted an application from the police to remand Chidinma Ojukwu, the prime suspect in the murder case involving the late CEO of Super TV, Usifo Ataga, for 30 days. 30 days, and it's a very sad situation. It's I'm just going to read for you guys the whole story, okay, about what happened today. It says, the police have filed a remanded application before the magistrate court at Adeola Adeyemo. Miss Ojukwu Chidinma, a 300-year level student of the University of Lagos, was arrested by the police on June 23rd for allegedly killing Usifo, a secret lover, which we all know by now. Miss Ojukwu, who initially admitted to stabbing Usifo multiple times while they lodged in a shortlet apartment in Lagos State area of Lekki, later retracted a statement in an interview with the police media scene, which was aired by Crime Fighter TV, a police-sponsored program. Ojukwu claimed she walked into the room from an errand only to find a target stabbed, blood everywhere, and apartment in shambles. You know, at the hearing for the remand application today, the police prosecutor Cyril Ajifo told the court that the application was made pursuant to section 264, subsection 1 and 2 of the criminal law of Lagos State. Ms. Ojukwu appeared before the magistrate court alongside a co-defendant in the case, Quadri Adedapo. Ajifo said attached to the remand application is a 12-page affidavit statement of the defendant and an exhibit to show that the file has been duplicated to the DPP for legal advice. We are praying for the remanded defendant for the first court, Mr. Ajifo said. Representing the first defendant, Babajide Martins, director of the Office of Public Defender, said that the remand application is inevitable. Martins, who did not oppose the application, enjoined the prosecution team to make necessary document available to the defense before being brought before the court. Obviously, that's how it works. In a ruling, the magistrate court granted the remand of the defendant for 30 days. In the absence of anything to the contrary, the two defendants are remanded for 30 days in the first instance, Adebayo said. The magistrate then adjourned the matter to September 5th for the interview of remanding legal advice from the Directorate of Public Prosecutions. Okay, this is it, guys. Remember when I was, I think I made reference to how Chidinma was confessing, and I said she wasn't probably told about her right to keep quiet, because that's how it works. Like, if you commit any crime, see, the problem with Nigerian police is, I always see a lot of videos where they catch criminals, they're going to interview them, they're going to talk, blah, 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 blah. You see, those statements where they talk can be thrown out of the court if they have a good lawyer, because the lawyer can come and say, okay, my client was in. Told to, you know, you're not in the go now, you know, you are made your right to, you know, keep quiet, or whatever you use can be, you know, whatever you say can be used against you in the court of law. So it can attack that part and they go throw out the case. Obviously, that's what's happening here. That's where Chidinma come grant, you know, the other interview where she come grant, obviously, lawyer don't advise her on what to do. When she come say she wasn't around, she went for an errand, then before she come back, Usifo was killed. And stuff like that. So, you know, blah, blah, blah. We all saw the interview. And now, obviously, there's another suspect. So, two of them were brought to the courthouse today. And what happened is, they came from what we just read and from my own understanding. So, the court can't adjourn the case. You know, sometimes when you go court as a prosecutor, obviously, Nigerian prosecutors should know this. I know they know this, so I don't want to go there. You're supposed to, whatever findings that you make, whatever evidence that you get, you're supposed to send them to the defense lawyer. That's how it works, okay? So the defense lawyer will get the copy, and, you know, they can also work on their cases and stuff like that. So that's why you see sometimes when defense see the case to be very like, okay, this is a very difficult case, they will approach the prosecutor for a deal. That's how you did. That's why you see deals and stuff like that, or can reduce the sentence for you to plead guilty. So obviously, for this case, the defendant wasn't given the whatever they find is, so probably the court can't adjourn the case due to, you know, legal process and stuff like that. So this case is very interesting. Why I say interesting, because a lot of Nigerians are really not having it, you know, because how a person where they say he killed someone can't begin to get the enter private car, the Concorde, you know. So that's a bit crazy and a bit barbaric, because it's somehow Nigerians are really, you know, like, okay, this person says in a private car, okay, and one other person committed and said, so another person can't commit, and I saw them, they carry year one day for private car. Later, she was released by Ajimobi and flown out of the country. Nigeria is a country where murderers and thieves have right to do as they please. And this other person, the village headmaster, obviously that's the name, he said, gives more credence to the fact that she was doing someone's bidding. If needed, that is the car with her in front driver's seat, then there will be no justice for the real killers of Usifo. I wonder why the family are so quiet about this case. This other person says, gives more credence to the fact that she was doing, okay, whatever, we read that already, has no security now. Wow, which one is private car again? Allow police to do their job. That's what someone else is wrote. This person says VIP treatment. Anyways, it's somehow, we don't know what's really happening with this case, but for Chidinma to enter private car, not just a private car, you know, front seats. I mean, it makes no sense to start with, because the car feed the emotion, and she feel open the seat on the door and just, you know, jump out and then commit suicide. People are not, I don't understand people these days, though. I mean, let me not just go into this case. We'll talk about this in our next video. So guys, thank you for watching my video. If you're new here, consider subscribing. And to my returning subscribers, thanks for always coming back. Love you guys. We're doing this, we're making it happen. God bless you, and don't forget to steal of crime. Crime not the pay. Crime not the pay in whatsoever way, guys. Please, do what you gotta do. Do it legitly. You know, keep your head up. Life not JJ. Life not JJ. No worry in life. You know, my beautiful people. So, let's keep hoping for the best in life. You know, guys, share this video. Let me know what you think on the comment section below. Remember now, gist with the gist, we're not really the come discuss, people matter. So kudos guys, I'll see you in my next videos. Alright, cheers, bye.